The symptoms depend on each patient. Each patient can present with a different type of symptoms, but most commonly we look for skin, lung, or muscle. The patient might develop some erythema over their knuckles, and usually most people don't pay any attention to it, especially if they're fair skinned. This can be common. But the significant part would be that this would be new occurrence. The patient wouldn't have those before. Another thing that can happen very early in the disease, and it's not unique for dermatomyositis but any kind of rheumatic diseases, is Reynaud's. Reynaud's is the phenomenon where the fingers, when they are exposed to the cold, they turn white, totally white, and then might change colors like red or purple. When it appears after the age of 25 or 30, then it means that something is going on and the patient needs to be evaluated for rheumatologic diseases. Other early symptoms of the disease is that the patient might develop an erythematous rash on sun-exposed areas, like the face, the upper chest, or upper back. But this can happen even if the patient is not exposed to the sun, or if the patient is exposed to the sun, then the rash doesn't go away with time. Another thing that we often miss is the scalp. The scalp can be an important part of dermatomyositis. It can be affected and cause like scaly rash and a lot of itching. And that can be misdiagnosed as other conditions, but even though the patient is using topical shampoos, it doesn't go away. So that would be an indication that the patient should be evaluated for dermatomyositis. Then the symptoms of the muscle, as we said before, it could be progressive muscle weakness. The patient first notices that they cannot hold their arms above the head for a long time. They have difficulty getting up from a chair, especially from the toilet seat because it's lower than usual. And they notice that they have to use their arms to climb up and stand up. One of the early symptoms could be difficulty climbing upstairs because it needs extra effort and extra strength. That could be also a sign of early lung disease because in dermatomyositis, the lungs can be affected. And they have progressive shortness of breath, especially on exertion. Like where they see that before they could run like a mile, now they can only run like half a mile because they get short of breath. So that needs to be evaluated as soon as possible. We consider severe symptoms of myositis the symptoms that can send the patient to the hospital. So these are two, either the shortness of breath or dysphagia. Shortness of breath, it comes from most commonly from lung disease, which means the condition where the lungs are inflamed and the patient cannot take a deep full breath and oxygen cannot reach the tissues. If it happens suddenly, it can be severe and the patient needs to be hospitalized. Another severe symptom is dysphagia, which means that the patient has difficulty swallowing. So these are the severe symptoms that need to be evaluated as soon as possible. So the trajectory of the disease can be different depending on the patient. In some patients, they have one-time symptoms, we treat them, and then they never have any symptoms again. Or some patients, which are the majority of the ones we see, they will have flares of the disease, which means it's well controlled, and then for some reason, they can get again a flare of the disease. Usually, there is some trigger behind it, like infection, underlying malignancy, or even stress can cause the flare, but sometimes we're not able to find out why these people have again a recurrence of their symptoms.